Hey, Warrior Saints. Father Chris here. Today on The Way of the Warrior Saint, we're going to talk about communication and listening to other people as you talk with them. We came to our favorite coffee shop, The Henry, here in Scottsdale, and we're going to go through a short but hopefully important discussion of how to shut up and listen. Come on. In today's conversation on The Way of the Warrior Saint, we're talking about communicating with other people. And in conversation, it often becomes a very difficult thing for people to listen. We're talking too much. I have been known myself as one who's quite verbose. In fact, I think I talk a lot. And I'm learning to battle that by shutting up and listening. Have you ever been in one of those conversations where another person is speaking, or you're trying to communicate with somebody, and they say something, and you're not really listening? All you're doing is waiting until it's your turn to talk again. You know what I mean? You know those moments where they say something that triggers a thought in your mind, and you're already formulating your response because, ooh, this is a good one, I gotta say this. Or they don't understand right, let me show them this way. Or perhaps even I'm gonna offer some better or even more beautiful insight than what they're trying to say. And perhaps we're right in those things, but also perhaps we're wrong. We'll never really know unless we listen. And so what that means is that we have to stop that immediate reaction inside of us. We really have to battle with that stuff because it's totally hard. I do it all, look, I'm the worst. I do it all the time. Somebody says something, I immediately think in my mind how to respond, and I stopped listening to them. So the first thing we need to battle is to slow our mind down so we can actually listen and focus on the words that the other person is saying. This way I can actually hear them. The second issue, and this one's a toughie for a lot of people, especially in the volatile times in which we live, and the landscape of America today is one where everybody hates everybody else if they don't agree and think like they think. And so we have these inflammatory statements, you know, about something that we believe in or something that we're passionate about. We hear something said and we immediately become angry or defensive, or we want to go after them, and we're now formulating this vitriolic response. What I have found in most conversations, because I really believe this, really like 5% of things in life really matter. The other 95% is just silly, idle talk. And so we've allowed ourselves to be subsumed or consumed. I like that word better. Consumed by the silly talk. And we stopped listening to what the person is really saying. So like if somebody says something, we talked about this before, so forgive the example, but it's a good one. I like President Trump. I don't like President Trump. Why don't you like President Trump? I don't like President Trump because he is a narcissistic, woman-hating, misogynist, blah, 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 and all of the things that we say. Now, if I am one who supports President Trump, and I hear people say things like this, my immediate reaction is to jump on them, to attack their position, to immediately go after why they're wrong and why there are holes in their arguments. Now, I may be very right. I may be very wrong, but either way, I stopped listening to what the person was saying. And by listening, I don't mean just hearing the words attacking a specific individual person. I mean listening to what's coming out of their lips as a window into what's in their soul, right? Because a lot of that kind of stuff expresses the hurt or the brokenness or the sadness or the despair or the despondency that we feel inside. In the book of Proverbs, chapter 18, verse 13, it says, if one answers before he really hears, it is to his folly and shame. And so I'm saying that most of that type of commentary is not really what we hear on the surface. There's deeper things, there's deeper hurt, there's deeper connection being desired. And we get so caught in that quick vitriolic response that we stop listening. And we don't hear what really matters. And so we're focused on that 95% and we left the 5% that's real, that's true, and that matters, we've left it to the side. So when we communicate with another person, here's what I'd suggest. And look, I'm not the expert in this field at all. It is something that I am devoting myself to right now and working very diligently at because I suck at it, to be honest. But here's what I would suggest, and here's what I'm trying. Number one, make sure that you communicate in a 2-to-1 ratio. And what I mean by that is, for every one story you tell, let your communication partner tell 2. Right? So what this does, it gives a little bit of balance so that I'm not usurping and dominating every conversation, which I tend to do if I'm not careful. It also gives the other person the impression that you really are interested in what they have to say. And hopefully it's more than just an impression you give, but it's a real statement that you really are interested in what they have to say. Number 2. See if you can focus and concentrate and draw in your mind a mental line of all of their thought and their reasoning, right? Before you jump into a quick response. When you do that, like we talked about earlier, you know, there is that people don't really listen. We just wait until it's our turn to talk again. Maybe if we try to understand exactly what they're saying and to try to draw the line in our mind of what's their reason, what's their logic, what's their thought, I might be able to, you know, to put together a clearer picture of what my friend, what my spouse, what this other person in front of me is really trying to say. And the third one is, when someone says something that is inflammatory, that really makes your blood boil, feel that. Experience that and talk to yourself in your mind about the anger or the emotion or the hurt or the whatever the emotion may be, the anger, the hurt, the sadness that you're feeling, and say, why am I feeling this way? Right? And I think when I ask myself that question, I start to realize, because that person has pushed my buttons. And though a conversation may or may not actually be about the content of what they're talking about, their pushing of my buttons has caused me to stop listening. And then I'm going to respond to their vitriol with vitriol of my own. But if I can ask myself, why am I feeling this way? And even better, a corollary question to that is, why would they do that? Why would they try to hurt me? I'll usually come to the conclusion that they wouldn't try to hurt me. They don't want to be deliberately malintended, and they don't want to be a jerk. So maybe there's something heavy inside them that's coming out, that's being expressed in those angry conversations. And so all of a sudden, I'm now able to say, though they may have said President Trump is an X, Y, or Z, what they really may be saying is, I'm feeling scared, or I'm nervous, or whatever other emotion they may have in their minds. And if I can listen to this, this stuff means nothing. This is of no value. This is the 95%. Focus on the 5%, and that's where real communication can happen. So, beloved, today's point on the way of the warrior saint is pretty simple. Shut up and listen. That means shut up, and that means shut up. Close your lips so you can open your mind, so you can listen to what the other person is saying. Embrace them as a human being who is your partner in a conversation. Perhaps you'll find yourself getting into a better conversation, a more healthy one, a more lasting one, a real one. Till next time, keep walking on the way of the warrior saint. See you soon.